In 3, 2, 1, roll that bitch. I'm reporting to you live from Trump headquarters, pussy-grabbing capital of the nation, here to mark the words of the great Donald Trump as he marches into the White House like an erect phallus making its way into the pubescent cavity of the nation. I think this is the greatest moment that we will ever experience. I don't care you live through the moon landing and the Berlin Wall coming down. The pussy-grabbing king is going to take his throne come January. Get that black guy from Hawaii, who says he's from Hawaii, out of the Oval Office. The Oval Office. That's a place for the Donald. The Donald is going to institute new pussy-grabbing policies for this whole country. Make it far more acceptable. We got marijuana legalized and pussy-grabbing demonized. That's just wrong. The two practically go hand in hand, don't they? Because if nobody has said this. I'm going to say this. I'm Clovis. I'm going to say something nobody has said. If you're a man, right, and a woman who's rich as fuck, got her own airplane, got her own buildings all over the world, she comes up smiling at you, she strokes your hair, she gives you a kiss, she grabs your Johnson, are you really going to take her to court, or are you going to smile right back? Well, most guys know the answer to this question, even if they give a different answer in front of other people. But the Donald, he grabs a few pussies and suddenly you want to nail him to the cross. It's a double standard. It's a double standard right there. Ain't right. Ain't right. The only man that can make this country great twice, and you're going to nail him to the cross for grabbing pussies, which is his God-given right and urge and inclination to do. Mrs. Clovis, reporting.